guys. So here we are going to understand about the drawback of Rutherford model. Okay, so what is the drawback we have for Rutherford model and why we discarded it? Okay, so what happens, according to electromagnetic theory, whenever a charged particle in motion, right, whenever a charged particle is in motion under the influence of an attractive force, right, the charged particle must emits energy in the form of radiation. This is the electromagnetic theory, right? Electromagnetic theory suggests what? Magnetic theory, a charged particle in motion under the influence of an attractive force emits energy in the form of radiation. Okay, so in every turn the charged particle has to emit energy. So for example, suppose the electron is moving in this path. Since it is moving under the influence of an attractive force which is towards the nucleus, it has to release energy in every turn, right? And that is why it won't follow the same path in every turn. Since it is releasing energy continuously, that's why the same path it won't follow in every turn, and it has to change its path like this, and it will follow a spiral path, and finally it should fall down into the nucleus. Okay, so like this the electron is moving in every path, right, and then it falls down into the nucleus, right, which makes an atom falls in the nucleus, which makes an atom unstable. When the electron falls into the nucleus, the atoms become unstable. Hence, but the atom is quite stable, that we know already, right? So hence this postulates of Rutherford model does not stand true with the electromagnetic theory. This is the problem or drawback with this model we have, and hence we have discarded this particular model. Okay, also the another thing, Rutherford model did not talk about the orientation of electron, the velocity of electron, the energy of the electron. There were no information about all these for this electron and all, right? That's why we have discarded this particular model, right? And again we get a different model that we call it as Bohr atomic model. But to understand Bohr atomic model, we have to understand the dual nature of matters or light, that is wave nature or particle nature. So next class we'll discuss first the dual nature of matters, then we'll go to the Bohr's atomic model. Thank you.